And we are about to bring on a very important guest that everybody should know this name all across America. And everybody should look to this name and trust this name for their medical health and sound advice. Friends, it is such a blessing and such an honor and a privilege to have Dr. Stephen Soloway on the show with us now. Dr. Soloway is a world-renowned physician. Patients come from all over the world to be healed by Dr. Soloway, to be seen and evaluated by Dr. Soloway. He also has many patents. He is also known as Dr. Trump. And he just came out with a new book called Bad Medicine. The requests are off the charts. It's going to be flying off the shelves. You'd be lucky to get your hands on it and to hear this incredible man, this incredible doctor speak. It's called Bad Medicine. We're going to find out from Dr. Soloway how you can get your hands on it. But this is a great American patriot, somebody who loves our country and who serves the people every day by treating and healing so many people that come to him for help. He's going to join us now, and it's such an honor and a privilege, Dr. Soloway, to have you on the show. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning.
Thank you. You know, Dr. Soloway, you joined us on the last show.
And I loved it.
And you were amazing. And this show...
I was the best.
Yes, my phone rang off the hook. Everybody wanted to know, really, how they could come and meet you, how they could hear you speak, how they could...
They have to buy my book, and then I'll meet anybody
that buys my book. No, but how they... And, you know, I have been saying this for a long time. We need a Dr. Soloway TV series where you come on and you talk about medicine and also policy and politics. Why?
Absolutely.
Because, yes, so much of what happens in Washington affects our health care and our ability to see great, extraordinary physicians like yourself. We had this incredible show. And guess what happened, America? Let me tell you what happened. We were shut down. That segment was shut down and considered hate speech. Now, keep in mind, fellow American citizens, not one word of profanity was spoken. There was no hate speech. There were no threats. This was simply a great American patriot and doctor speaking truth. And then what happened next? Well, Kiara, who's here, and she can speak to this, as well, received a notice that segment of our show was shut down for hate speech. Now, mind you, there's no appeal process whatsoever. Whomever these hate speech police are, decided that they didn't like our show because Dr. Soloway is fearless. He's not afraid to speak truth to power. He's not afraid to say the truth. And he doesn't drink the Kool-Aid. He cares about the health and well-being of the American people. And then the next thing we know, Kiara gets a notice, right, Kiara, that says that the segment was removed for hate speech. Basically, there are so many options that you know, so many chances that you get before they shut down your entire YouTube channel. But yet there's no appeal process. So you have somebody that wants to silence us, that wants to silence we the people, that wants to silence a great man like Dr. Soloway. It's outrageous. So what do we do here at the John Frederick Show? We bring Dr. Soloway back because we are not going to allow the bad guys to silence us. So here, Dr. Soloway, what say you? Were you shocked and surprised like I was?
I was mortified. It was the best show. It was my best performance.
Yeah.
It was the truth. It was everything you wanted. It was factual information.
Correct.
From my book, which is going to be a bestseller because it talks about what's good, what's bad, what's wrong, who's right, who's wrong. It was all opinion,
yeah.
And there were some facts thrown in about COVID.
Yes.
And for some reason, the left-wing radicals that own the country and own the media decided, you know what? Anybody who has a thought for themselves needs to be shut down because that's a threat to the government. And the reality is there's just a billionaire class of people that own these billionaire companies. So, for example, YouTube shut us down. Who owns YouTube? Google. Who has lots of money? $30, $50, $80 billion at Google. And the people who own Google, they're the ones proposing to the Nancy Palousers of the world that the taxes should be increased to 900,000%, and yet with $50 billion, I don't know if they're adding $40 billion to their tax return and leaving the rest of us alone, because the rest of us are just peasants compared to them. And this is really how communism gets started. This is how Nazi Germany got started. You shut up the people. You keep them stupid. You keep people like me off the air. You don't let us talk. You don't let us write. And again, you just keep regular people stupid, and you hide the truth. That they're doing a great job. They're doing an amazing job. But you guys are so strong, and I am so smart, and my book is so good that we're not giving up.
No, and you know, and I love this. Now, I want everybody to hear the passion in this man's voice. He is saying, listen, I'm not backing down. Dr. Soloway is saying, I'm not going away. I'm not backing down. Try as you might to silence me and to silence we the people, it's not going to happen. And I love that passion. I love that fire. That message needs to be heard from sea to shining sea. You know, I hear what you're saying, and you're absolutely right. And the problem is that first of all, we need more Dr. Soloways in the world, because you're not afraid. You're not afraid. You're fearless. And that's exactly what we need. We need fearless leaders like you speaking the truth. You know, after your show, my phone was blown up. Everybody wanted to know how they can come in and be treated by you. And, you know, how can they do that? Because I know people come to you literally from all over the world.
I have people coming from as far as Australia, probably 10 or 15 European countries. And this week we had a patient fly two flights from South Dakota.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. And then, you know, your book is coming out, Bad Medicine. I love it. I love this book. You know, everybody I know wants this book. But really, you know, if you care about the future of our nation, if you care about medical care, if you care about, you want the truth instead of, you know, what the spin police and the fake media and the garbage that's spewed out of, you know, Washington. This is a tell-all medicine and policy book that everybody should have their hands on. Everybody needs to. If you care about our country and you care about the future of medicine, this is the book that you need. Now, tell everybody, why is your nickname Dr. Trump? Why does everybody know you as Dr. Trump?
Well, I'm the best.
Yes.
And everyone knows I'm the best. And if you don't know I'm the best, you got to read my book, and then you'll know I'm the best.
Right. That's right. And you know.
And you know what?
Yeah.
So I compare myself to Donald Trump because Donald Trump is very inspirational. Donald Trump knows how to live life.
Demands excellence.
Donald Trump knows how to get things done.
Yes.
Donald Trump expects and thinks that everybody around him is at his level, and that he's to expect the best out of everyone, so that everyone and everything can thrive, more jobs can be created,
right,
more people can make more money, everyone can be proud to pay taxes because the government actually protects us, because if we want to pay no taxes, we can gladly move to Venezuela or Somali and not pay taxes, mm-hmm. but we need to have our own tank and you know, our own secret service. So they call me Dr. Trump because I put in 12 and 14 and 16-hour days. I see people nonstop. The quality of care is A+. It's as good or better than any tertiary care center in the United States, and I won't even mention the other countries because we're the best. And, you know, people come here from the NIH. People come here from Johns Hopkins. People come here from the Mayo Clinic. There's nobody who gives better care in my specialty than Steve Soloway, the best, period.
That's right. And you know, tell us a little bit. You know, right now we are living in such extraordinary times where the American people are being inundated with, you know, panic, anxiety, stress. The world's coming to an end. You know, everywhere you go, there's this misinformation out there. And yet the Washington Post headline was something like, it wasn't exactly like this, but it was something like, you know, right-wing media is to blame for the spike in coronavirus.
Okay,
I mean,
well, I hate to cut you off, but I got to tell you, you just hit another nerve, because when I was telling you how we were taken off YouTube, because who's YouTube owned by? Google. Okay, well, obviously Amazon owns, or Jeff Bezos owns, the Washington Post. So you're not getting opinions of people. You're getting Jeff Bezos' hand-on opinion of what he thinks. and he's the rich liberal left who wants you to raise your taxes while he doesn't want to pay his employees and he doesn't want to pay extra taxes. If Bezos would give $90 billion of his $100 billion and Zuckerberg would give $40 billion of his $50 billion and Sergey Brin would give $60 of his $80 billion, the rest of us could keep the same damn tax rate.
You're right.
The Washington Post will come out and say everything is the right wing's fault. If you're a conservative, then you need to be silenced.
That's right.
The Washington Post is owned by the left, and therefore, because it's in Washington, the average person thinks it's the be-all and end-all. It's the Bible. It's God. It's the Quran. It's whatever you want it to be.
Mm-hmm.
But it's anything but the truth.
That's right. And, you know, you see people in your practice. You've seen thousands upon thousands of people from every walk of life. And at the
hundreds
end
of thousands, by the
I'm
way.
Sorry, hundred, pardon me, hundreds of thousands of people. And, you know, they come from every walk of life, every race, every creed, every belief. And at the end of the day, I always say that Americans vote with their pocketbooks. I mean, at the end of the day, no matter who you are, no matter what you believe in, there are certain basic kitchen table issues that resonate with everyone. And so, you know, several of them that we are seeing unfolding now, it's basic safety, basic, you know, the safety of our homes, our families, our children. We've seen looting, we've seen burning, we've seen bricks being thrown through buildings, you know, absolute destruction.
Worse, the statues are coming down. History
yes.
is being destroyed.
Our history is being destroyed in our great nation. And it's very scary for many Americans. But at the same time, we have voices like you reminding everyone that we are the greatest nation in the world and we are going to fight to defend our freedom and we aren't going to stand by and let our history be erased.
He actually has a voice of common sense.
Correct.
That wants to deal with the pain.
That's right. That's exactly
right.
We have
right. people avoiding the pain. And now we have Dr. Soloway that wants to deal with the pain.
That's exactly right.
This nation cannot be healed unless we deal with the pain.
Amen.
They want the pain to continue.
Right. That's exactly right.
All the way through Election Day, by the way.
That's exactly right. No, you're absolutely right. Yeah. This is Leon Benjamin, candidate for Congress, served our country, and we need to send him to Congress because he, like you, Dr. Soloway, is going to fight to defend our freedoms. So when you're in your practice and you're seeing all of these patients, you know, at the end of the day, they want good health care. They want to have a safe nation. They don't want to live in fear. They want to know that when they call 911, a police officer is actually going to show up. And yet, Dr. Soloway, the left wants to defund our police force. Who's going to come to our homes to protect our families when there's an emergency?
Chuck Schumer, he'll show up in a Batman suit.
Okay. You know what? I don't know if I'm going to be able to get that image out of my head now because it's really scary. But yes, no, you're right. I mean, that's what we're dealing with now. And you know, not only are you an industry leader, I know you sit on many different boards. America's top doctor, you know, clinical professor at Drexel. Clinical associate professor at Rowan, you know, chairman department of rheumatology division with the Inspira Health Network. You know, you're featured in all these magazines, Philadelphia Magazine, New Jersey Magazine, Top Doctor. What do we need to do to fix America's healthcare system in two sentences? I know that's impossible, but, you know, what do we need to do to fix our healthcare system? It's a mess.
Okay, number one is the first concept is to realize that up until 10 years ago, the system worked very well for 90% of the people.
Mm-hmm.
And the left wants to overturn and destroy the system for the 10% that are uninsured. So the first thing is to figure out how to fine-tune the last 10% and not destroy the 90% that works. That's the most important
yes.
thing.
Yes.
The second thing is the part of the government that controls healthcare, namely Medicare, Medicaid, and even the VA, because that's all government, and the one that funds the military, TRICARE. Those four divisions need to be wedged and molded into one division and pull the money and stop people from double-dipping and stealing. There's people that go to the private office with some private insurance because they're stealing it off their cousin's ID or Social Security number, and then they run over to the VA and get free medicine. So those are my two things that you can find in chapter 5 or 6 of the book. And all this is in the book. I elaborate on this in the book. If you don't get this book, you're dumb, okay? Everyone needs this book.
Well, absolutely. And
I will sign everyone's book if they buy the book.
Yes, so I've already gotten requests from the last show. People want you to come and speak, want to have an autographed copy. So folks need to line up because get your hands on this book, Bad Medicine.
It's, you know what? If you don't buy this book, your city's going to turn into Seattle, and your mayor's going to need to go to prison for treason like the lady in Seattle.
Well, listen, before we go, I'm going to let everybody that's listening know something about you. And that's Dr. Soloway is not only a brilliant, genius doctor and great American patriot, but he also collected one of the largest baseball collections ever. Baseball card collections ever. And you know, something that people could only dream of ever accumulating, ever. And I know you're an expert in that, and we want to have you back on another show to talk about that, because we have to wind up this segment. But would you do us the honor of coming back and talking to us about your collection?
You know, I think that if you ask me nice, I'll consider it.
Okay, very good. Friends, this is Dr. Soloway, a great American physician and patriot. He just came out with a book that's going to be flying off the shelves. It's called...
Its release date is August 18th.
Yeah, the release date is August 18th. It's called Bad Medicine.
But go to Amazon.com and order it on Amazon.com right now.
Yeah, right now, if you're hearing our voice, you care about our country, care about our medical system, right now go to Amazon. Dr. Soloway, the book is called Bad Medicine. Get your hands on it before they run out. Dr. Soloway, thank you. It's been a privilege and an honor. We can't wait to have you back on. And let's see if the bad guys try and take this segment down. We're just going to keep having you back.
You know what? If they take us down, we'll start a riot and it'll be fine.
Dr. Soloway, everyone, this is Martha Bonetta on the John Frederick Show. We'll be back soon.